Hello, everybody. Hello. Thank you. And good evening, Arizona. So great to see everybody tonight. I am very humbled to be here. And I'm also confident that when the votes are counted, that we're going to be successful in this mission. Now, this doesn't feel like a typical election night. And this hasn't been a typical year. And that's why tonight, it's not about celebrating. Tonight is about getting to work. And I want to start off by thanking a few people. Gabby, my best friend, the ultimate partner through this campaign and in life. Gabby's the person who taught me about this side of public service and what it means to use public policy to improve people's lives, and who taught me to never, ever give up. She also has a lot more experience at this stuff than I do. So thank you for your advice, and especially the tough advice. Now, I couldn't do this without you. To my two daughters, Claire and Claudia, thank you. Now, we've been through a lot together. And this is a little different. When you were young and I'd leave on a spaceship for a couple weeks. But just like those missions, I could not do this without your love and your support. And I'm so proud of both of you. And Scott, well, I guess we finally found something that sets us apart besides my good looks. That's right. Don't forget that. And last, but definitely not least, to everyone who chipped in a few bucks, who made those phone calls and sent texts, knocked on doors, volunteered, or worked on this campaign. I mean, this would not be possible. It would not be possible without you. So thank you so much. Now, when we launched this campaign from this very spot right here, 619 days ago, I could have never anticipated just how many Arizonans would be part of this mission. Because this mission has never been mine alone. And I have to say, it goes back much further than just a couple years. I wish my parents were here to see this tonight. Both of my parents were public servants. They were police officers in my hometown. My mother passed away in 2012, and my dad in 2016. And I wouldn't be here if it weren't for my parents, but especially for my mom, for the example that she set for Scott and I, and the sacrifices she made for us to have the opportunities that we did. Now, when we were growing up, our mom worked as a secretary and a waitress, often at the same time. And then when we were in junior high school, our mother became the first female police officer in our hometown. And it wasn't easy for her. She overcame great odds. And a lot of folks doubted her. And she showed me what it meant to work really hard to come up with a plan and accomplish a goal. And that's what led me to buckle down and pursue my own dreams of flying a Navy jet and then eventually the space shuttle. You know, my mom raised two astronauts. I don't think she expected that. She probably didn't expect this either. But like so many others, my mom wanted to give us the opportunity, the chance to achieve our dreams, whatever they may be. February of last year, when we launched this campaign, that it feels like a lifetime ago. We traveled through all 15 counties and heard from so many of you across Arizona. In a senior center in Parker, I heard about the concerns about rising prescription drug costs and the future of Social Security. At Eastern Arizona College in Thatcher and Mojave Community College in Bullhead City, I spoke to teachers and students about how to get young people the skills they need to succeed. And I spoke to a group of much younger students in Prescott about what it's like to go into space. And on the way back home, like so many of us, we stopped at the Rock Springs Cafe for a slice of pie. And in Mesa, I toured the Asian district and listened to small business owners and leaders talk about their successes and their challenges and their vision for building a more prosperous and inclusive community. Then the pandemic hit. So much changed so fast. It became harder, but even more important, so much more important to hear from Arizonans. So we took our conversations first online and then outside with masks and social distancing. It was over video that I spoke to Local First Arizona about what locally owned businesses were going through and how they were trying to deal with this pandemic and how difficult it was for them to access the loans and the grants they needed to keep paying their employees. And it was over Zoom with dreamers and advocates that we celebrated the Supreme Court's decision to uphold the DACA program and talked about the need to provide a pathway to citizenship for dreamers. Sitting in our houses, I spoke with mothers like Patricia and Melissa, whose children were born with pre-existing conditions. They were so concerned that those protections would go away. And with Ophelia, who told me from her kitchen table in Mesa that she was struggling to pay for her prescriptions, her son's prescriptions, and her other weekly expenses, like groceries. Weeks later, Ophelia and I spoke again over the phone after she lost her son to COVID-19. And then outside Crescent Ballroom in Phoenix, I heard from Bill, whose wife, she survived a tough fight with COVID, but was still dealing with it. And from Kristen and Tara, who lost their fathers to this virus. I carry each and every one of those conversations with me. And I'll carry them and countless others, other stories, your stories, with me to Washington, D.C., to be your senator. Because this mission does not end when the last vote is counted. It is only the beginning. Now, when I was at NASA, we would train for 2 years for a space shuttle mission. 2 years of being in the space shuttle simulator and flying and training, and 2 years of focusing on the details. 2 years before we were on the launch pad ready to go. And then the work started. Now the work starts. And we desperately need Washington to work for Arizona. My top priority is making sure we have a plan to slow the spread of this virus and then getting Arizonans the resources our state needs right now so they can make ends meet, keep our small businesses afloat, and get the testing and health care that we need. Right now, Arizonans who can't find work because of this pandemic are trying to get by on $240 a week. That doesn't cut it. There are small businesses in Arizona that are weeks, if not days, away from closing their doors, or already have. Those businesses and the jobs that they support aren't magically gonna come back unless they can stay afloat. They need a lifeline right now. And so do the schools that are trying to safely educate our children. Then we have to address the larger challenges that have been exposed and made a lot worse by this pandemic. That's lowering the cost of healthcare for all Arizonans. That's driving down the cost of prescription drugs. Now, I'm going to work to do that. And we also need to rebuild our economy, and it's going to be a massive undertaking. And we just can't rebuild it. We have to reinvent it and make it work for everyone. And that means creating the jobs of the future and getting Arizonans the skills they need to fill them. Arizona's economy, it has always depended on key economic drivers like trade and tourism and supporting our national security. We have to support these industries as they recover But we also have to protect Arizona's military installations that are so critical to our national defense and also to our economy. And we have to bring more innovative companies to Arizona. To do that, we need a highly educated workforce. That requires that we invest in high-tech job training, an affordable higher education for Arizonans, and in infrastructure, not just in roads and bridges, but in broadband, and not just in cities, but in rural Arizona too, and Arizona's tribal communities. As we tackle these challenges, we have to do so in a way that addresses racial inequity and levels the playing field. And there's so much more we need to do to provide a pathway to citizenship for dreamers. We need to secure our border. We need to tackle climate change and secure Arizona's water future. There's only one way we're going to solve these problems, and that's by working together. Now, some of you watching tonight did not vote for me, and that's okay. I'm going to be your senator too, because our state doesn't need a Democrat senator or Republican senator. We need an Arizona senator, a senator like John McCain, who I looked up to as a young Navy pilot. When we were in SEER school, that's the place you go where they teach you to do what you need to do in a situation if you're shot down. He was the model of how you honorably survive an impossible situation. It's not often that we get to meet our heroes, and it's even less often that you get to ever call them a friend. I got to do that with Senator John McCain, and it meant so much to me. Now, Senator McCain and I, we did not agree on everything, but I had such admiration for how he approached the responsibility of serving in this very Senate seat, willing to stand up to his party when they thought they were wrong, willing to work with anyone on a good idea. I mean, he left a legacy of service to each other, to Arizona, and to our country that will never be matched. It lives on through his family and as an inspiration that all of us should strive for. It's what we need right now, to be focused on finding common ground and solving the challenges in front of us. And those challenges are large. But if there's anything I learned from my mother in serving at NASA, and what I learned from Gabby is there's nothing we cannot achieve if we set our minds to it and work together. So let's get to work, Arizona, and let's do it together. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.